Well, after the pickup truck incident last week, I have followed through with my threat to put the Pope here on the dashboard.
Right.
Hopefully he will protect us, and at the very least, he might assist me in my pontification. Avast and heave to, weigh the anchor.
What, again?
Well, yeah, it does seem redundant, doesn't it, to always weigh the anchor, but it's on a checklist. It says weigh the anchor, set the sail, and then put the rudder amidships. So even though it's always the same exact weight, we're supposed to weigh the anchor every time before we go out. The reason we're talking all nautical is because today's show, we're actually going out on a naval battle, not so much a reenactment as just having a naval battle with tall ships from about 3 years ago. I went out on this thing because I found these guys, and that's what they did for a hobby. They went out on tall ships, and then they shot cannons and muskets at each other to try to see who was the better naval captain and who could get a midship broadside attack on the other guy, and so on and so forth. So they have a lot of fun doing that, but I can't find these guys. I don't know if they're still doing it. In fact, I don't think they are, because one guy sold his ship and the other guy moved to Hawaii. So I don't know if anybody's still doing this,
does
but
not
I took
sound promising.
It doesn't sound promising, but I did take a million stills last time when I went out. So that's today's show. We're going to look at this great fun naval battle that these guys did about 3 years ago that they would do just kind of as a hobby to see who could be the best 18th century sea captain.
Very cool.
Well, we've seen some pretty extreme hobbies on Toy Man, but one of the most extreme has to be building a recreation of a 200 to 300 year old sailing ship, and then getting together with others with similar ships and fighting a war. We're going out today to do just that. The ship that we're going on is called the Bill of Rights, and it's a two-masted schooner. A schooner has the advantage of speed, but it's not as maneuverable as the ships we're going up against. The ships we're going up against are the Lady Washington here in the foreground and the Hawaiian Chieftain further to the back. These are also two-masted, but they're square-rigged ships. Very maneuverable, but not as fast. The Hawaiian Chieftain here is just flat bristling with cannons, and that makes it a little intimidating. The Lady Washington has no gun deck. It has guns on its main deck. But boy, what a beautiful, beautiful ship it is. Well, once we've rendezvoused out on the high seas, everybody gets into their position, and then the signal is given, and the battle begins. The crew here is a bunch of landlubbers from the Gold Coast area. Everybody has a little job to do when they go on these rides. The captain here is in the black coat. He's got one of the volunteers on the helm. And we're just getting ready to undertake battle, and here comes the enemy. Hundred years ago, naval battles were fought in pretty darn close because the guns weren't that accurate or that powerful. There's actually some risk of just running into each other. Avast and heave to! Actually, I only heaved once. I got away with that one. I'm not sure which is most amazing, that we're recreating 300-year-old naval warfare, or just the sheer beauty of the machines that we're messing around with here. While these ships look incredibly old, they're quite modern. They have steel hulls. They even have hidden diesel engines for those times when you don't really want to be under sail. And they're quite capable of sailing the entire world. Yeah, this takes yachting in some kind of a totally new direction, a rather extreme hobby. But hey, this is the Toy Man after all. So after a fine day of fighting naval battles, we take the toys home and put them away for the night, and then head home remembering an absolutely amazing day at sea. Was a lot of fun. You have to admire these guys. I mean, how over the top is it to build your own tall ship, a 18th century and 19th century tall ship, and then just sail it around?
That would be cool.
And these guys getting together so that they can have naval battles with each other is even more over the top. Now that is an interesting hobby for sure. Well, if you haven't been over to the channel, that's on YouTube, Toy Man Television. There's also the website, toymantelevision.com. When you're on the YouTube channel, do subscribe so that you will be notified of all of this fun and frivolity as it becomes available.
Right.
I'm not sure how you found this particular movie on the internet. I sure hope you didn't find it boring. And we will see you here again in 1 week with some more significant Toy Man screwing around. We'll see you then. Bye.
Bye.